1956, his father escaped from prison in Hungary when he was facing life in jail for fighting against communism and the Soviet invasion. His mother escaped at the same time, and they fled to the UK. He learned from an early age how to fight the war against fascists, communists, and Nazis. He became a world expert in fighting terrorists, wrote the book Why We Fight, joined the Trump team on the White House staff in 2017, and now, in 2019, he takes this battle to a national radio platform. This is America First with Sebastian Gorka. Welcome to the new age.
Let's go to Long Beach, California. Ted, line three, welcome to America First.
Hey, there's an issue that's, I think it's underappreciated and it's very serious. There was a guest on Martha McCallum the other night, and it was a Trump voter, Trump supporter, who had resigned himself to believing that since the Trump administration's legal teams have lost in all the courts, that maybe it's time to move on. And I've realized, of all of the Jake Tapper's most famous lies, he loves to keep repeating that Trump's legal teams have lost in 62 courts across the United States.
Right.
And I've asked him on Twitter many, many, many times, can you name the court that actually agreed to hear evidence, hear eyewitness testimony, see the analytical data from the data firms that do business with three-letter agencies in the United States government? They've been on TV. They presented to state legislatures. Seen the unfolded so-called mailed-in ballots, seen any of the evidence, weighed the evidence, listened to rebuttal witnesses, then rendered a decision based on the evidence. Can you name the court?
You tweeted this at Jake Tapper?
All day long. I'm on, by the way, I'm Eagle Eye News Network on Twitter, so I follow you. There is not a single court in this land that they were in. They got to the door and had their petitions rejected. And what's dangerous is there are a lot of Trump voters out there who are resigning themselves to the fact with a shrug. Well, yeah, you know, the courts looked at it and, maybe there is no evidence. It never happened. If it did, it would have been a media event.
Yes.
It would have been a 2 or 3 day process. They would have been waiting for the decision. They would have been talking about the witnesses. There is a lie being perpetuated that is nullifying and snuffing out real factual opinion about whether or not there was even evidence in the first place.